Joanna Gosling. Hello.
More exciting tomorrow.
You think?
Yeah, I promise.
You're hoping. All right, Jamie, thank you very much.
Where's that?
We're just running through all our cameras to see that they're all working.
Checking they're all good.
Those two are working. This one's working too. Hello.
Good evening and welcome to BBC News. I'm Martine Croxall. It's 9 o'clock. I'm just going to move back to the main set. I know this has happened before. But here we are. If I sidle in, you can pretend that you haven't noticed. Here we are. Lewis Hamilton has won the Formula One.
Well, yeah, there's martial law in the border areas of Ukraine. There is not martial law. Oh, my, the background has just gone crazy on the screen.
Well, I'm just not pulled in the ICC
very of funky.
Kiev, I'm afraid.
You were just going to tell us there's no martial law in Kiev.
Winter day, autumn night, snow, winter night. We can have the full range. But anyway, it is very cold and wintry here in Kiev.
A test of your calm, cool, collected presenting skills.
Well, you know better. I can put another 10 p.m. if you wish. We'll go back on autumn. Anyway, as we were saying, as the night returns to us shortly.
Hey, there it is.
Yeah, so Vladimir Putin has said that he considers everything that happened in the Kerch Strait. We're starting again. Here we go. back to the Kerch Strait on Sunday.
Good afternoon.
Because not everyone thinks he did a good job. But what we can say is that it looks for him in Uxbridge also something where there may be some concern. He had a 12,000 majority here.
12,000!
It's now down to 5,000.
5,000!
Some people think it won't happen again.
It won't happen again!
Thanks very much, Tim. Lots of people trying to get in on the act there. Our political editor, Tim Donovan.
This is BBC News. I'm Carol Walker. The headline.
I'm terribly sorry. We've had this problem before, haven't we? I'll make my way back to the desk and tell you about our lead story tonight, which is that the Boston Marathon bomber, Dzhokhar Tsarnaev, has been sentenced to death by a court in the United States. Three people died, you'll recall, and more than 260 were injured in the bombings 2 years ago.
He'll be joined by viewers on BBC One when Clive Myrie will have...
Sorry, yes, they did say that he has had a very difficult year, and as was said by his lawyers, he had already, had a bit of a crash behind us there. I mean, such is the media crowd there. It has been very busy here today. Yes, we do know that Amit Partland has had a very troubled year.
Hello and welcome.
Hello, this is The Briefing. I'm Ben Bland, our top story.
For the wider region, I think one of your children has just walked in. I mean, shifting sands in the region, do you think relations with the North may change?
I would be surprised if they do.
The cub was taken to an animal management centre and is reported to be dehydrated, but otherwise well. Gosh. Now, let's have a look at the weather with Louise.
Yes, from one tiger to the...
Beg your pardon? Where are you going with this one?
I'm not going to go there. Let's talk about the Winter Olympics, shall we?
Yeah, Simon? Because that reminds me of Pyeongchang.
Those are the main stories. One other story for you, though. A giant planet, Earth, measuring 150 feet wide. A giant planet.
A giant planet Earth.
A giant planet Earth. No, that
can't
be right.
Measuring 150 feet.
I get it now.
There you go.
Tonight at 10, jobs and prosperity must come first in any Brexit deal. The Chancellor spells out his priority.
But Sarah Vasey, Adam Peaty, Siobhan Marie O'Connor, Ben Proud and James Guy, congratulations. Oh, sorry, I didn't see the step. Sorry about that. Well, that's giving you all a good laugh. Adam's inconsolable there. Just look before you're getting in a swim pool in future, okay? I hope you can still hear me. I'm going to have to get rather close and mind the step. Can you continue, Sarah? Because we want to talk about your goal. You don't want to talk about me falling in the water. But everyone's, all the people watching here are literally on the floor. Well, I'll hold it together. You don't have to. Congratulations. Tell us what it was like.
Okay, so and we'll just stay on those pictures for a moment. We just explain what's going on. If you didn't see it a second ago, Mike is carrying on talking, but we can't hear him because a moment ago Mike fell in the water and his pack went in. He doesn't know. We can't hear him now. But goodbye, Mike. It's not been dull.
You just, honestly, you know when live, we'll leave, bye-bye Mike, we'll come back to you.
Kate Silverton here is having to, you know, he's having to go like this to get out of the way of the cameras. Could you get you out there? Shot. Oh, well, that looks wrong. Let's have a look at the weather. Ben.
Well, no. I was going to talk to you about sunsets. Oh. Do you know, well, okay, we'll have a little... I normally have to deal with one of him, two of you. I mean, this is terrifying.
Too much to cope with.
Exactly. Yes. So. Yeah. But look at this.
You're a bit discombobulated, aren't you?
Can we get a shot of these
we
two?
We haven't done this for a while. No, I quite like
this
it.
Is
can
like
I stay?
News
I feel safer
circa.
Here.
Do you? Yes.
I bet.
Me and you on the dance floor. You're just 20 kills in the rush to get out.
But right, you carry on.
Well, are you still? Oh, you're still on air. Yes,
I've done this bit.
Have you? Oh,
yeah.
Well, what about a forecast then?
Thank you. That's what we'll do now.